Does your child throw sand, rocks, or other similar material on the playground? In this short video, I'm going to give you a step-by-step plan to stop your child from these dangerous playground behaviors and keep them and others safe from flying sand and rocks and etc. Hi, I'm Holly McLean, the Mommy Answer Lady. I'm a certified parent educator, mom of nine, and author of the book and online course, How to Train Your Child to Behave. There's new content that comes out on this channel just for that purpose every week. So please take a moment right now and subscribe. Before I get started, I want to let you know this short video is about children throwing sand, rocks, or other playground materials and can also be applied to other things on the playground. But if your child is throwing things like toys, clothes, or food at home or at a friend's house, you can see another short instructional video on this channel that will address those issues. I'll put some links here at the top in the description below also and at the end of the video to get you to those resources. So you're at the playground with your child and you notice they are throwing sand or rocks at the air, just having fun. Obviously, this is dangerous and can hurt them or others. How do you stop it? Here's the plan if you have not addressed it with them before. Number one, call the child to you. Have your child come to where you are sitting. Now, this is part of the plan. Rather than getting up and walking over to where they are, part of the consequence of throwing inappropriately will be that they must stop what they're doing and travel to your location. If you go to them, this is one less part of the consequence for that behavior, so make them travel to where you are to address the situation. Now, if you call them and they do not come, go to them and make them come with you back to where you were sitting. Then address the situation. By the way, there is another video on this channel that addresses how to teach a child to listen when you speak. So if they don't come when you call, you may want to check that one out. Number two, explain the problem. One of the keys to parental effectiveness is clear communication. In the eyes of a child, throwing sand or rocks is just plain fun. They don't understand the dangers or problems with it. So explain how sand can get in their eyes or the eyes of others, and it can cause a person great harm. They may even have to go to the doctor or hospital because of the scratches and damage it could do to their eyes. Now, sand and rocks can also get in their hair and others' hair, which is difficult to wash out and makes a mess in the car and in their home. Additionally, you can tell them sand or rocks are usually in a specific area for a purpose. If everyone throws them outside of where they're supposed to go, that will cause a mess and the playground will not be as well taken care of for others as it should be. Now, all this information will be news to a child who has not had it explained to them before. Make sure they understand and discuss this with them. Ask them some questions to see if they understand. Number three, explain the consequences. Let them know that if they decide to throw sand or rocks again, the consequence will be that they will not be allowed to play where that material is present anymore today. They will have to play elsewhere or sit out. Number four, allow them to try again. Now that your child has the information needed to make a decision about their behavior and they know your expectations, because you've clearly communicated, allow them to make a choice to obey. They should not get in trouble if they didn't know the details and have an understanding of your expectations, but now they do. A compliant child will obey and likely will not throw it again. You probably won't have to worry about this anymore, or at least during this play session. Now, a seesaw child, meaning a child who commonly changes from compliant to strong-willed depending on the situation, will be curious to see what will happen if they do it again. They will likely throw again to see what you will do. And a strong-willed child will look at you and throw the sand or rocks again, showing you defiantly that they will not comply. So number five is take action. Call the child to you and let them know that they threw sand again after you had told them not to do so. Because of this, they will need to sit out of play and they will need to apologize for their disobedience. Then let them sit and think about what they've done. Let them know when they're ready to apologize for their disobedience and putting themselves and others in danger to let you know. The amount of time that this will take is completely up to them. It may take a minute or two or several minutes, but don't beg or plead with them to do this. Allow them to sit and think and make the decision when they're ready. Now, if they throw a fit, remember to apply the CTM method. If you don't know what that is, see the instructional video on this channel, and I'll put a link above, about how to handle tantrums. Number 6, when they're ready, have a discussion. When they come to you, make sure they don't just say, "Sorry." Have them explain what they are sorry for so they are clearly communicating it to you. Now, if they refuse, tell them that's okay and don't force them to apologize. Tell them if they aren't ready to fix the problem, they can go back and sit until they are ready. Now, once they apologize with the explanation of what they did, then let them know that they will not be allowed to play where there is sand anymore today, or rocks or whatever it was. Tell them this is the rule for today, but next time you come to this playground, they'll get another chance to play in that area and try again. Number 7, be consistent. The key to parental effectiveness is consistency. If you've explained your expectations and your child knows this and the consequences for not complying, your consistency will make them understand when you speak, you mean business, and they will much more easily comply in other areas as well. If you've received value from this video, please take a minute right now and subscribe to this channel. And you can also see more step-by-step instructional videos by clicking on one of these cards. Parents, you can do this. Thanks for watching.